Hello and a very good day. My name is Faizatul Nazifa binti Zulkifli and my metric number is BR18110019. Today I will be talking about a review of vertical farming technology, a guide for implementation of building integrated agriculture in cities. We can live vertically, so why can't we farm vertically? Due to limited access to land for farming, there is a need for sustainable farming tasks as to pave the way for adding food needs. Many aspects press on food industry and processing, such as growth of population and its growing needs, accordingly reduction of natural resources due to growing cities, and many more. The answer to these issues is vertical farming. Vertical farming has grown a project which combines the design of building and farm altogether in a high-rise building. By definition, vertical farming is a system of growing crops in skyscrapers to maximize the use of land by having a vertical design whereby plants, animals, fungi, and other life forms are cultivated for food, fuel, and fiber by artificially stacking them vertically above each other. This research tries to review techniques and technologies that are used in vertical farming projects all over the world. For the methodology in this study, a qualitative approach was chosen for assessing and analyzing current vertical farming practices. In the first step, we identified existing and future vertical farming projects which were done regarding related websites, media, and literature research from 2009 to 2017 and resulted in a total of identified projects in Europe, Asia, and America. In the next step, a comprehensive literature review based on the analysis of different documents published in accessible international resources on technologies and techniques that were used in the vertical farming project. The study resources were formed from 63 different sources, types such as journals, conference papers, theses, books, as well as standards, a report from Web of Science, Scopus, ProQuest, as well as Google Scholar. Next, one of the main technology in vertical farming is the general structure itself. For instance, as to supply 15,000 people with food, a high-rise building could be designed with these properties. The size of a vertical farm should be 93 hectares, about the size of a block, 37 floors, 25 of which are just for producing crops, and 3 for aquaculture. Moreover, 3 floors of the same distribution are for adjusting the environment, and 2 located underground are used for keeping waste. Furthermore, one floor is allocated for the cleaning of growth trays and germination, one floor is for packing and processing the vegetable or fish, and another for selling the products located underground. This makes the overall height of the building 167.5 meters and its length and width equal to 44 meters. The building is also equipped with a spacious elevator to fit a forklift truck, and this helps transport the harvest from down to other floors. Each day, about 217,000 liters of water is needed for the system. As to obey the key role in local food production, a ground floor of vertical farm needs to be a grocery store or a restaurant in which the products are sold to the public. For the material technology, usually the skin facade of the building is made of self-cleaning and clear material, for example ETFE, which is ethylene tetrafluoroethylene. Also, a material with fantastic transparency and thermal rate are needed to raise the amount of sunlight that arrives to the building. Next, the lighting technology. Lighting is a key issue in vertical farming to manage the production line, whether the vertical farm is planned to be totally using artificial light or using both artificial and natural light should be taken into account. There are 2 options available, the LED or the HPS. In a vertical farming, any decrease in the density of stacking inside the building is accompanied by increase in the building cubature. Although natural daylight is the main source of energy received from the outside, there needs to be daylight concentration, direction, and distribution strategies conceived so as to use sunlight effectively throughout the seasons. When stacked above each other, even when the farm has transparent walls and lets most light in, there is not enough light reaching all layers, especially those below. Consequently, there needs to be artificial lighting used to supply energy for vertical farms. As shown in the picture, the buildings created are to maximize the use of sunlight to reach the plants. Now, there is also an option to use solar cells to be highly efficient, especially in the photosynthesis of plants, in order to use the energy of the sun maximally in vertical farms. Now, the waves should be filtered since they are not absorbed by chlorophyll. The employing of red and purple colors with the highest degree of absorption to 535 nanometers as the basis of dye synthesized solar cells can be a useful way to produce selected solar cells for the plants to grow. Next is the LED. As mentioned previously, besides natural light, there is a need for artificial lighting too, and one of the sources can be LEDs, which is light-emitting diodes. LEDs have longer life and lowering price are decent choices. Among their advantages are long life, efficiency in energy, the capability of targeting particular light waves to better manage the photo period. Another advantage of LEDs is that they regulate the proportion of red colors and far red to get the best response from plants. Next, technology for water required. When farms are transported into indoors, less water is lost due to the evaporation process, and it can be used back for the plant growth instead. The amount of water needed for hydroponic agriculture was estimated to be 1 liter for each square foot a day, or 10.71 per square meter. Contingent of the type crop, 200 to 600 liters of water is needed to provide 1 kilogram of dry product. There are a number of techniques used in vertical farming to resist the lack of water, which is introduced below. The water retrieval by means of recycling or dehumidification. For recycling, if the city water waste is recycled, it provides a good source of farm-specific water supply and make farms self-sustainable. Not only can vertical farms use rainwater, but they can also use grey water supply, which is, by definition, is water used only once. For example, used for showering, washing hands, or water collected from the roof of buildings. This water may be filtered and be reused for watering indoor and outdoor plants. Now, for the dehumidification, water is evaporated and gone accordingly may be again gathered and used. Water with all its nutrient contents enters the plant through roots, solutes get absorbed, and the rest of the water returns to the air through leaves. Now, this water that evaporates is without any pollutants once it leaves the plant. In vertical farming, this clean water that has been evaporated can be used again by dehumidification. The next technology is renewable energy. Vertical farms need the following: light and temperature for plants to grow, the energy needed for the technical equipment like conveyors, movement of plants, fans, ventilators, heat pumps used to manipulate the climate, pumps used to dilute nutrients, and agitators to control the environment. As cars and still growing even, vertical farming originates from an exciting background of renewable technology. Therefore, these technologies are dominant and there is hardly a way to push them aside. The sun is the major source of energy over the globe, but its rays raise the temperature of air and environment. As a result, this source of energy should be controlled if it is expected to harm the surroundings. The energy coming from the sun stands as a proper solution to energy problems via solar panels, solar walls, or trump walls. An efficient solar system in the past used electric lights, which produce 7% less light than they absorb. Next, technology is for crop selection. Almost all crop can be produced in a vertical farm as long as all the conditions to grow are met. The first thing to think about when choosing crops is to consider which plant is better to breed indoors. Because the limitations are imposed by height, plants that grow on trees such as bananas, olives, avocados, nuts are hard to grow inside because they grow tall. This way, more than 3 dozen types of vegetables can be chosen to grow inside the building hydroponically. Next is the hydroponic and aeroponic system. Hydroponic is a strategy used in farming which makes no use of soil. Rather than aquatic solution, is given to the roots of the plants, it provides every vital nutrient needed by the plants. It usually uses a cylinder-shaped growth system, typically made by PVC pipes, to hold the plants. These nutrients include nutrient film techniques, wick system, water culture, flood and drain, drip feed system, and aeroponic systems. As compared to outdoor agriculture, they save a lot of water. Such systems take advantage of gray water as previously defined. Plants that have grown with the help of hydroponics prove to grow faster, they get ripe in a shorter time, and yield 10 times more crops than a soil-based cultivation. Moreover, they contain more nutrients than crops produced in soil. Next is the aquaculture subsystem. This procedure is named aquaponics and used in indoor farms. In other words, it uses fish excretions to feed plants as nutrients in a closed water cycle. Similarly, it may use the rain gathered from the building roof and save it under the earth in order to fill flush toilets or fish tanks. In this system, there is a fish farm inside the vertical farming building which helps to rid of waste and act as a source of plant nutrients for the food production. Next is the controlled environment system. Temperature, air conditioning, and ventilation system are all important in designing a vertical farming building. The following privileges of HVAC, which is heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system, make it suitable for vertical farming, which is it improves indoor quality of air, saves energy, consistency of moisture and heat are easily to be controlled. The building which uses the least energy possible is highly efficient and saving energy. Another point to be considered is heating and cooling of building, which depends on the geographical coordinates of the vertical farm. Using regenerative energy needs to be supported by sensible and sufficient distribution of transfer system. The monitoring in vertical farmings with controlled environment systems are usually done by proper automated intervening tasks. Next is the waste management subsystem. In growing eatable biomass, vertical farms produce bio-waste in their product, like leaves, stems, fibrous roots, fruits, vegetables that are damaged, as well as those from an aquaculture system. As vertical farm is expected to work in a closed loop, the waste is supposed to turn into beneficial sources such as liquid fertilizer or biofuel. During a nutrient extraction procedure, wastewater is recycled and pumped in pipes full of volcanic rock parts. In designing vertical farms, there must be two floors for handling these wastes. Next technology is smart devices. As a totally automated operation, vertical farming makes a great use of sensors and actuators known as smart equipments. They also interact with other systems with no human interference. In order to realize that vertical farming as a technology, there needs to be a comprehensive calculating system which is constantly aware of the environment and helps to generate proper information and service. These informations about the context is required to make the right decisions about selecting the controller. For example, in the picture, the harvester is selecting which fruit is ripe enough to be harvested. Throughout this review, vertical farming has been identified as having excessive potential but also many constraints and weaknesses. So in order to better implement vertical farming, it is important to consider all the limitations and potentials. The following 3 points have been identified, which is more discussed in the literature and which therefore need further thinking. The first point is architect and designers should be presented with a set of sustainability criteria for the whole cycle of creating sustainable buildings. In the matter of agricultural technology view of vertical farming, these attempts need to cause secure and good quality food and other products of farms. It can act as the criterion to select acceptable tasks in each production phase, which are sustainable both environmentally and socially. And the third, as a reassuring idea, vertical farming integrates contextual matters in the economical, and it emphasizes the downsides of present farming and tries to solve problems according to prospective social status. The figure shown indicates how vertical farming can play a role in forming sustainability city areas. Next, optimally, vertical farming is required to be a cheap and affordable, resistant and securely operable not requiring financial subsidies or external support in case these conditions are met. In a dynamic, all-inclusive research programs, farming in cities can supply many foods for 60% of the population who resides in cities until up to 2030. Vertical farming has a potential success in proper conditions. It simultaneously helps to reduce poverty, adds to food safety, and increase contextual sustainability and human well-being. It is one of the activities that play a main role in supporting a human in the world. However, drinking water is already short, but most of the available fresh water is already used for agriculture. So, overpopulation of cities need new agricultural methods so as to bring conventional farming inside the cities. That is all from me. Thank you very much.